But it is good to see all of you this morning. I just wish God's blessing upon you. Pray for Kurt and all the pastors and lay people who are gathered at our annual conference every year because they make rules and regulations that they have to go by. And then the quadrennial comes around and they vote on all these things, put them into place. So remember them this week that they go through that. Now, they have another big beat than that annual conference. Let us bow our head and go to the Lord in prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, again we stand before your wondrous throne. We come today with knowing that we've been blessed probably more than we deserve. But that's just the kind of God you are, that you love us so much. Even when we were in sin or in sin, that you were there with the hand out, saying, just look, reach out, and I'll pull you up out of the muck and the mire that you may have fallen into. And we will use you. And I know that you will use us in a special way if we would just devote our lives to serving you. Father, we come today for to pray for all of the people here at our church and all the other churches throughout the world who are gathered here on this Sunday morning to lift your name up on high and praise you and to love you and to share the love that we have for one another, the kind of love that can only come from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, we pray for Cecilia today, and she's, I don't know what's going on, but Father, you do, and we ask your blessing upon her and those who are attending to her. We pray for Bobby, who is in the rehabilitation, trying to get up to where she can walk better and get back to doing the things that she wants to do. I know I visited with her the other day. She's tired and she just hates being there, but I told her, honey, you're not a spring chicken. And so we have to remember that, Lord, and we just ask your blessing to give her the strength and to know that she can overcome. And we know that what's going on with Cecilia, we pray that, that whoever's attending to her will find what the problem is and get her okay and get her back into our worship service that we have come to know her and love her and Curtis both. And we just lift them up to you, Father, and bring them to that old rugged cross. We know by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, healing can take place. And the day we expect a miracle in their lives, that things are going to change. And so we lift them up to him. We pray for our pastors. He brings the message today. Be with Pastor Kurt as he tries to share the gospel, whatever way that may touch our hearts today, that may change us, strengthen us, and maybe even give us more wisdom that we need to face each new day. We pray for the world, Father, as we think about what happened in London, all the terrible things that's going on in this world, Father. I don't understand. I can't comprehend those kind of people to do and just out murder people. It's just something I can't grasp. But yet I know that you have the power to help us, Father, through these things. And I believe if this world stopped praying, it would be a lot worse than what it is. But we lift all this world up to you, Father. There's a lot of evil in the world. We know it doesn't come from you. It all began in the Garden of Eden when sin came into the world, and sin has become horrific in this world today. And we lift all those people up, especially those who have been injured, those families who have lost a loved one. Continue to be with the leadership in London as they try to put all these things together and find out who did this and bring them to justice. Father, we lift our congregation up to you today. Bless it in the name of Jesus Christ and for your glory. Amen.